Ever since the release of Windows 11 version 23H2, Microsoft has made it increasingly more difficult to bypass this Microsoft account sign-in screen. But in this video, I'm going to show you a very simple method that still works on Windows 11 version 23H2, and I think it should also work in the upcoming version 24H2 release, unless Microsoft patches this method in the coming months. Now, the first thing to note is if you've installed the Pro version of Windows 11 23H2, once you get to this screen, you can just click on Back, and then you'll have the option to set up a work or school account. And once you've clicked on that, you can just click on the Sign In options, and then you can click on Domain Join instead, and then you can go ahead and create a local account on Windows 11 Pro. But the version that I have here is Windows 11 Home, version 23H2, and you'll see if I click on Sign In Options, there's no option here to join a domain because Windows 11 Home and Home Single Language don't support domains. So every time you go back, you'll just be taken to this screen where you have to sign in with a Microsoft account. And just to prove that I am on Windows 11 version 23H2, and it is Windows 11 Home, I'm just going to run the WinVir command. So you can see this is 23H2, that's the build number, and this is Windows 11 Home. So the step-by-step process that you need to follow is once you get to this screen, press Shift and F10 on your keyboard so you can open this command prompt window. Then the first command that you need to run is task manager, and you need to type taskmgr.exe and then press enter, and that's going to open the task manager here on the computer. Next, you need to run a new task, and the task that you need to run is a regedit. And just to be safe, just check this box you created with admin privileges. Once you've done that, click on OK. And then the registry editor will open. Now you need to navigate to the following key, and it's going to be HKEY local machine, then software, then Microsoft. Then you need to scroll all the way down to Windows and expand that. Inside of Windows, expand current version, and then inside of current version, you want to expand OOBE. So there is the exact registry key that you need to navigate to. And then these keys here, these are actually the keys forcing you to sign in with a Microsoft account, and you can delete these keys if you want, which will then load into a default user as a local account. But I don't recommend that you delete any of these keys. Instead, just right-click in this empty space, click on New, then click on DWORD 32-bit value, create a new key called Bypass NRO, then once you've created it, double-click on it to open it, and then just change the value data to 1, and then click on OK. Once you've done that, you can close the registry editor, and you can also close Task Manager. And now the next command that you need to run here is ipconfig /release, because you have to disconnect from your network connection that you currently have. So just press Enter so you can release your network connection. Next, just exit the command prompt, and then click on Back. And then you're going to be able to use a local account. So I'm going to enter a username. I'm going to call it user, then click on next. I'm not going to enter a password. I'll just leave it blank and then click on next. And then I'll just turn off all of these sliders and click on accept. And then I'll be taken straight into my local account on Windows 11 Home 23H2. Once you get to the desktop, you'll see that you're signed into your local account. If I click on change account settings, you'll see this is a local account and it's an administrator. If I go to system, to the about section, this is Windows 11 Home 23H2. Now you'll see that you don't have a network connection at the moment. You can just go ahead and restart your computer and the network will come back. But if you don't want to restart, you can just right click on the start button and then run Windows PowerShell as admin, click on yes, or you can either run command prompt as well. Then you can just type ipconfig /renew and then press enter, and it's going to give you a new IP address, and then you'll be connected to the internet again. So I hope this video has been helpful to you. Please like the video, and I'll talk to you guys soon.